the basic infrastructure of any community that is normally found any part of the world has been swept away. There's no vehicles here. Everything that you see here has been brought in from the outside. Imagine a situation from ground zero where on day one you have to set up the mechanisms to feed, clothe, shelter 275,000 families in a situation where everything, including the social structures, the governance structures, were swept away.
Is that why the relief effort has appeared to be slow to get moving?
Yes, I mean, in a situation like this, nothing is fast enough, but you have to understand that the first and second layers of first responders were literally swept away. They themselves were victims. They died. Their loved ones died. They cannot be found. They may be suffering from traumatic stress. It's only now that, according to the mayor, it's only now that people are actually showing up to work in City Hall. No, from the police in Tacloban City, out of a manpower strength of 293 on day one. I was here in the when the typhoon came. On 293, when I went to the police station to organize people, only 20 showed up. And by the way, that was only 50 or so 2 days ago. So that's why we have to augment everything from the outside. Trucks, I only have 8 trucks that are from the armed forces that are delivering goods and foodstuffs to the communities.
For the whole city? 8 trucks?
For the whole province. The total trucks under this system's disposition is 16 yesterday. 16. 50%, just to let you show you that, you know, there's some thought going into this. Out of those 16 trucks, one half we dedicated to delivering food, one fourth we dedicated to cadaver recovery, and one fourth we dedicated to clearing the roads. There's not much more we can do if we only have 16 trucks.